I just met with officials and workers from a great American company, Harley-Davidson. They told me without even complaining, because they have been so mistreated for so long that they've become used to it, that it's very hard to do business with other countries because they tax our goods at such a high rate. They said that in the case of another country, they tax their motorcycles at 100%. They weren't even asking for a change, but I am.
That was the president, of course, addressing Congress back in February. The president at that point made Wisconsin-based motorcycle giant Harley-Davidson really the poster child for why America needs some kind of a tax at the border, perhaps a border adjustment tax. In recent months, though, the push for that tax seems to have hit a political roadblock. The president has talked about other taxes, like a reciprocal tax, is what he brought up to me when we had our interview back in April. So how's that sitting with Harley-Davidson CEO Matthew Levatich? He is joining me right now to talk about taxes and to talk about trade. Matt, it's great to see you.
Nice to see you, Maria.
Thank you so much for joining us. So the president obviously just addressing Congress with that. It's all true, right?
Yeah. We had a great meeting in early February with the president of the administration. The focus on the nature of our business. We're a heavily invested U.S. manufacturer doing business in 90 countries, largely exporting our U.S.-made product around the world. And in a lot of cases, in particular in some high-growth markets like Asia, there are significant tariffs and other taxes that make access to our products really limited. And it's a big issue affecting our ability to grow in really important motorcycle markets.
Well, this is a really important motorcycle market because that's where the growth is for you in Asia.
Yeah.
But when you sell a motorcycle in India, they charge you 100% tariff?
Yeah, so a motorcycle shipped complete to India has 100% tariff. We've actually invested in what we call a CKD plant in India so that we can take the higher volume products that sell there and avoid a certain amount of that tariff by producing or assembling locally in India. And that's a strategy that we've used in Brazil since the late 90s and a strategy that we see being very relevant to Asia going forward given the high tax structure.
And
tariff structure.
There's China as well. When you sell motorcycles in China, you're charged 90%.
Yeah, right. And there are other taxes besides just tariffs, so luxury taxes and VATs and things. And one, in the case of Indonesia, it's almost four times the government tax burden is almost four times what the product is at a landed basis. And Indonesia is the third largest motorcycle market in the region.
Wow.
So these are not small issues for us as a company. We appreciate the opportunity and the interest of the administration. We had a great dialogue and discussion about those issues. And as they think about how to formulate policy, which, as you pointed out, is a lot of political pressure from a lot of different directions on some of the different strategies. But ideas like that are very beneficial to companies like Harley that are heavily invested here in the United States and trying to grow in markets around the world.
And of course, this has been going on, so you are used to it. This is just the way business operates for you. But the president is saying, look, if China is charging our companies 90% and India is charging our companies 100%, we should have some kind of a tax. So lawmakers right now are having, behind-the-scenes meetings. I understand that they are working on tax reform as we speak. What do you think about a reciprocal tax? Should we have that? Should we be charging Chinese companies a 100% tariff or 90% tariff?
Well, so first of all, the trade environment is very complex. And so we don't have a like-for-like trade-off on motorcycles, for example, with China. So it's very difficult for the USTR, in this case, to negotiate wholesale agreements that don't generate the interest either in the other country or from other industries. The United States have different dynamics. So it's understandable why there's a lot of political energy around this topic, because there will be gainers and there will be losers. In general, we think free and fair trade is good for not just Harley-Davidson, but good for the United States and good for the world. And that's what we advocate when we talk with the administration. And recognizing it's complicated, but these things should be pursued with a lot of gusto because they're very valuable.
What about the overall tax blueprint that you're hearing about? The president would like to take the corporate tax rate down to 15%. The House is at 25%. Maybe they'll settle on 20% or so. How big of a deal is that for you as a corporate leader, looking at corporate taxes going from 35% all the way down to something in the 20s?
It's a big deal because our effective tax rate is around 35% because almost all of our costs are here in the United States and our foreign income comes back here. We don't have cash parked overseas. So we are paying, in effect, MSRP U.S. taxes. And so any relief there is helps Harley-Davidson, helps our investors. If we aren't able to invest the cash, return it to shareholders so they can invest as well. And a lot of these policies are designed or intended to help U.S. investment, which is good for jobs and good for the economy. And so we're in favor of the direction. It might take different forms, but generally speaking, whether it's corporate taxes or some of these border adjustment or reciprocal taxes should help U.S. and the U.S. economies and U.S. companies.
So you think that's the route to go. What about health care? As a business leader, how much of an issue has the cost of health care been for you as they try to reform this Obamacare system?
You know, we offer, as most big companies do, a very comprehensive health kit. We're self-insured. We've been focusing on wellness with our employees because the cost of medical care continues to rise at an unprecedented rate year after year after year. So it is a big issue. My own perspective is that there needs to be more discussion about why the costs are so high. Most of the discussion tends to focus on who's paying, whether it's the actual person who needs the health care, their employer, or in cases of Medicare, Medicaid, the government, or through Obamacare, et cetera. So the cost issue is a big issue for our economy, period.
Yeah, which is why you're focused on wellness.
Right.
Get ahead of the disease.
Yep.
Get ahead of sickness.